A South Carolina bill aimed at keeping drunk drivers from getting behind the wheel is gaining steam in Columbia. Emma's Law is headed to the House after passing a unanimous committee vote yesterday. WYFF News 4's Liz Loheis has the story. New at 11.
The parents of 6-year-old Emma Longstreet refused to let their daughter's death become just another statistic. She was killed on New Year's Day 2012 by a drunk driver. The Longstreets have been pushing to pass Emma's Law, which would require first-time DUI offenders with a BAC of 0.15 to install an ignition interlock device. That device would keep them from starting their vehicle if they were under the influence. A key vote Tuesday sends the bill to the House.
A lot of emotions. I'm excited.
Emma's father says the more than year-long fight has been worth it.
All the parents that have kids that go to cheerleading camps and soccer games and all those years they get to spend with their daughter, I'm not going to get to spend anymore. So I took all that energy and that effort and compacted it into this bill.
According to Mothers Against Drunk Driving, South Carolina has one of the nation's highest death tolls from drunken drivers. This past weekend, troopers say a woman and her mother were killed by a drunk driver in Cherokee County. 19-year-old Austin Shackelford was charged with 7 felonies in the crash. In court Monday, he apologized and said he wished he could take the victim's place.
It could have been prevented. That's the hard part about it.
One of the victims, Tanya Titi, worked for the Spartanburg Housing Authority.
She had the heart of gold. People here call her an angel.
Her co-workers and the residents she served are devastated over the loss.
She was so well-loved. Any resident you would ask, still crying over the fact that she's not here.
Valerie Forsberg says she fully supports Emma's Law and hopes it will prevent tragedies like this from happening in the future.
If a person has a DUI, hopefully they'll only do it once, because if they try to get in the car and drive again, you know, it would catch them.
Liz Loheis, WYFF News 4.
A vote in the House could come as early as next week. If it passes, Emma's Law would go back to the Senate.